Common sense tips from Leon's. Don't cry over spilled milk.
Recognize this voice?
You can't be in two places at the same time. And you can't miss Leon's common sense event with the
If you don't, maybe you'll recognize the face. Harvey Atkin is not only the famous voice of Leon's, but the famous face of Sergeant Coleman on the Emmy-winning TV series Cagney and Lacey. You may also have seen his face in the movie Sorry, Wrong Number with Lonnie Anderson and in Speed Zone with Sherry Belafonte. He's also made guest appearances on Street Legal, ENG, and various other television shows. The Thornhill resident originally founded his career in radio, television, and film 30 years ago and began pursuing it without any formal training.
The first major thing I did, I think, was the movie The Silver Streak. That was the first thing with Gene Wilder and Richard Pryor, and that was the first major movie I did. And then, of course, the biggest thing I've done, I think, was Cagney and Lacey for 7 years in Los Angeles. And, of course, I've been doing the voices, the voiceovers all along, all the time. They've been in the background for the last 25 years. Cagney and Lacey, the original pilot, was done here in Toronto with Loretta Swit, not Sharon Gless. And they had auditions here, and this was touted as being a pilot for a series. Yeah, right. They didn't really just do the job. So, you know, he did the thing, and then we got a call about 6 months later from Hollywood, and the guy said, would you like to come to Hollywood? And I said, hello, who is this? You know, somebody fooling around here, and I didn't think it was really real, but they invited three of us that were in the pilot to come down and do the series.
While Harvey Atkin considers himself fortunate to have gotten the role of Sergeant Coleman, this is how he describes his years of working on the series.
Hell, it really was. It was really tough. It was, you know, we were doing basically a one-hour movie every week, and we did this for 6.5 years, and it was really tough, and it was a lot easier getting up to the number one spot, but once we got up into number one and we won all the Emmys and everything else, it was really tough staying there, and it was really, people don't understand how demanding a series is. I mean, I still lived in Thornhill at the time, and I commuted every week. I flew back and forth to Los Angeles because I wouldn't live there, and it was really tough. It was a wonderful experience and something a lot of people would give their right arm for, and I'm very thankful I was able to do it, but it was a tough, tough grind.
Can I get this?
Hi, Morty.
Hi, sir. You got the rules?
No, I'm looking for candy.
Atkin may also be remembered for his role in the hit movie Meatballs, starring Bill Murray. He auditioned for the role of camp director, and that's exactly the role he got.
And I went for an audition, and I auditioned for the crazy camp director, and I got the part, and then we spent that summer doing the movie, and it was crazy working with Bill Murray. It was actually a terrific learning experience working with Ivan Reitman, who was the director, because I learned a lot about comedy, and no matter how much you think you know, you learn a lot more by someone. And of course, Ivan Reitman has gone on to do all kinds of things, Legal Eagles and Beagles and what do you call it, Ghostbusters and that kind of stuff. But so I've worked with a lot of good people.
In between roles, Atkin keeps himself busy with voiceover work for various radio and television commercials. In addition to the award-winning Leon's commercials, there are a few others striped with Atkin's voice.
It's time to change your underwear.
Goodbye, Toulouse-Lautrec.
Hello, Harvey Woods.
Sweet dreams, Rip Van Winkle.
Chrysler, Head & Shoulders, McDonald's, BCTEL, Goodyear Tires. I do a lot of cartoon voices, too. I was the voice of the Super Mario cartoons for about 4 or 5 years. I'm the voice of the monster. You know, that guy and stunt dogs and all kinds of this swamp thing. So that I enjoy doing those, too. Those are characters that you create in your head and you put them onto tape. So those are nice to do. Those are nice gigs to get, but they're few and far between. And you get known as a voice specialist, too. They're nice to do. They're tough.
And exactly why are character voiceovers the hardest to do? Atkin explains.
Because there's nothing, I mean, you have a script, but you've got to come up with the voice in your head, and it's a fictitious voice, and you've got to do all kinds of things with your voice. It goes up, and sometimes it goes down, and sometimes there's accents, and sometimes there's all kinds of those things, and you have to remember from day to day which character you were. And sometimes if you're doing two or three characters, two of your characters end up talking to each other, and you have to make sure you got the right voice in at the right time. So it's interesting. It's really interesting.
While he manages to make the finished product sound like it was a piece of cake to produce, Atkin says there is quite a bit of skill involved in doing commercial voiceovers.
That's the most difficult part of the business. That's tougher than being an actor on camera, off camera, etc. You have to be consistent. You have to be able to read. You have to be able to do it in a certain time. Your diction has to be right. You have to have you cannot have any regional accent in your voice at all. You got to make sure you don't say a lot. And write and things like that, and you have to be consistent. You have to be able to come back 6 months later or 2 weeks later and be able to have the same voice that you had the first time you did the spot, because if you're in a campaign, it's got to sustain, And there's an art to it. It really is. I mean, if they say they want the commercial done in 28 seconds, they want 28. They don't want 26. They don't want 31. It's tough. It's the toughest part of the business is doing voiceovers and things that, such as that, commercials.
Buying now makes sense. And remember,
it's a nice day, isn't it?
Don't talk to strangers.
As far as how long he'll be the voice of Leon's, Aitken says, you never know.
Hello?
The advertising business is very, I shouldn't say fickle, but it changes. Depends on the mood of the public. And as long as the advertising campaign is working and people are buying and Leon's is selling and it's working, I guess I'll keep doing it. I've got some more to do tomorrow morning.
Over the years, Aitken's work has been rewarded, as have some of the commercials he's helped produce.
Leon's has won a tremendous amount of stuff for their humorous awards, some motorcycle awards, some car awards, just announcing awards for different voices, cartoons, things like that. A couple of awards from the States for CBS. I used to do the promos for CBS for Matlock, the show Matlock, and we won the best humor award for all of the world, as a matter of fact, 1992. We won the London International Award for Humor for those particular commercials. It was done with myself and Tom Poston in Los Angeles. And I'm very proud about that one. I've got several international Clio Awards, which are sort of like the Academy Awards of commercials, and Bessie Awards for Canadian stuff, and Genie Awards for movies and stuff. You know, a few little things here and there. Maybe I'll sell them when I get old.
As far as current projects, Aitken has two he's working on.
I'm doing another CBS movie the week next month with Richard Crenna, another Janik series. I'm the coroner. They're bringing back that character. So it's you bring to every new job, you bring to it all of the things you've done before. So everything is different. That's the exciting part of this business. Everything, it's all make-believe, and everything you do is something new that you've never done before.
The other project is something York Region residents won't have to turn on the television to see. That is, if they're in the market for a new set of tires.
Well, I just thought that one day I'm going to wake up and maybe the pipes aren't going to be there and I'm going to start talking like that and I won't be able to do so. I'm just looking for something with a little bit more security, and a very good friend of mine and I decided to open up a tire store here in the Thornhill business, and we've got a tire store now. It's called Crazy Al the Tire Man, and we sell tires to the stars. Nah, not really. I mean, I figure that everybody needs tires, even in good times and bad times. If they don't buy new cars, they keep the old ones going, so they got to keep put tires on them. So the only thing that we can give that's better than anybody else is just service. So we're two crazy guys, and we sell tires, and we put them on, and we balance them, and all that kind of stuff, and it's fun.
As Harvey Aitken continues to work on various jobs in both radio and television, there's no doubt you'll be able to find the local celebrity working on his latest project here at Crazy Al the Tire Man in Thornhill. For The Regional, I'm Nancy Heiber.